Hey fellow supporters, welcome back. I'm here after being lost into the mumble and jumble of the exams, attending the conferences and whatnot. Anyways, the first thing to do in today's video is the announcement of the giveaway winners. Are you excited for that? So the first one to win the giveaway is, drumroll please, Creative Hunter. Congratulations. And the second one to win the giveaway is UK's Oriel. Congratulations to both of you. We only have two giveaway winners because the winners were selected for being active participants of the channel, and they were the only two to comment back on a community post related to the giveaway. So make sure to keep your eye on my community post. And for the winners, please contact me through the mail and claim your PCB. So moving to the topic of today's video, I am going to have a brief overview of this Poudell Spot Welder, which is a spot welder based on Arduino Pro Mini, and we will look at its hardware features as well as software features, and we will also look at its performance. So stay with me till the end of this video and don't forget to subscribe. You can also like this video and maybe even share this video with your friends. So let's get right into the video. The hardware features that it offers are 0.96 inch clear white OLED that displays all the information, a precise and snappy rotary encoder as an input, Arduino Pro Mini as the main microcontroller, and electrically isolated control signals by the use of optocouplers, support for a foot switch or an external thumb switch, replaceable welding electrodes with 10 gauge flexible silicon wires with proper copper locks, 1000 amperes of maximum switching current, and solid construction with copper reinforcement on power electronics. Battery voltage monitoring and low voltage shutdown are some of its hardware features, and moving to the software features which it provides are, users can set the pulse time from 5 milliseconds all the way up to 70 milliseconds by rotating the encoder. Users can long press to save the pulse data, single press on the rotatory encoder to weld, and press it twice to open the main menu. It has easy to use graphical user interface to change the settings. It supports multi-pulse weld like 1P, 2P, 3P, up to 4 pulses. It has 3 dedicated modes which users can choose to make a spot welder of their budget. It supports low battery shutdown, and users can set the threshold voltage for different batteries that they are using. If the user wants, the low voltage cutoff could also be enabled or disabled. And also in the About section, you can scan the QR code to find me on YouTube. And at last, by clicking on Back, you can exit the menu and come back to the home screen. The pulse time is not changed just by rotating. You need to first save the pulse time by long pressing on the rotatory encoder, and there is an indicator in the top middle of the display to show that. Battery voltage is shown over there. Below, we can see the low threshold voltage, and that square indicates whether low voltage protection is enabled or disabled. If I save the data and reboot it, the values of the pulse time, pulse count and all the other settings will be saved to the EEPROM, so your values won't get lost after a reboot. Enough listing out the features, let's now test them in action. By the way, you will need a battery of 5000 mAh or 6000 mAh of at least 60C discharge rating. You could also use an automatic battery capable of delivering more than 500 amps for a good weld. If you purchase this from me, then you will get everything you need for your first weld at $100, excluding the shipping. But for now, I will be using this crude foot switch for testing. But first, let's set the pulse to the lowest setting, and always remember to save the pulse data after you change the setting. And for the first weld, I will set the weld to 1P and see how it does. The strip is a 0.1 mm coated nickel, so at first we will try to weld this.
Oh, it broke. So I think if I increase the pulse time to 10 milliseconds, it will hold good.
And this time the pulse seems to be a bit stronger. So let's see.
I applied a lot of force to it, and I must say it was a good weld. It eventually came out not because the weld was weak, it was because I was strong. It was a good welder. And there are holes in the nickel strip, which means it tore apart from the battery. Let's try doing this once again with all the previous settings and see what happens.
Okay. And this one seems to be nice.
The sound you just heard was not made by me in the voiceover. It was actually me trying to take that strip out of the battery. It is just the 1/20th of the power of this welder, and the result is this. You could definitely weld even thicker nickels on the batteries. Now, believe me, this is not going anywhere unless you play 1v1 match with the battery. Let's see once again which would make a bit more practical sense. And this is how, my friends, you weld nickel strips to the batteries. There is one last thing to share with you all, and that is the low voltage protection feature on this thing. Let's say during the welding, if the battery voltage falls below the threshold voltage that you have set, then it will give an alarm and stop the welding. I know this is a made up situation for now, but you will definitely encounter this when you are building up large battery packs. You can also disable this if you have to weld anyways by going to the settings, but it is not recommended and it could harm your batteries.
Push this loose off.
The last thing to say is that if you want to purchase this Poudell Spot welder as well as support my works and this channel, then please visit the description section for more information. And thank you all for being with me till the end of this video. See you all in my next video. Till then, bye bye.